what your assignment is, yes. Because his seal is upon your life. Did you hear what I said?
Uh-huh.
His seal is upon your life. So your hands are important. They represent love for people who use them in a loving way. But also, hands signify power, because man's evils continuously are evil in the world today. His falsities. You hear about the evils and the falsities of man, the lies and the deceptions, the manipulation. Man's hands are doing all kinds of evil.
Yeah.
You cannot turn on the news without your heart breaking down about what man's hands have done to someone else.
Yeah.
It's not bad enough that they can take their own life, but they take other lives. And then it's not bad enough that they take other lives, but they take children's lives.
Well,
even babies' lives. So I submit to you today, saints, that the Bible says we were born in sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we were shaped in
it. Yes.
Iniquity means evil. Evil is all around us. We cannot get away from it. But with these hands, we need to find out what our unique creative purpose is in God, so that we can move forth under the anointing and do all that God has called us to do.
Mm-hmm.
But in the Word of God, it said that his people continuously find ways to be disobedient.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Look at your own life. I'm not talking about you. You just look at your own life and you see where you have maybe stepped out of the will of God and had to cry out for God to save you.
Yeah.
In my life, I've had to do that.
Mm-hmm.
I've had to walk outside. I've had to cry because I walked outside the will of God.
Yes. My God.
That's right.
That they had been here before.
Right.
That God had dealt with them about this before.
Right.
They did evil again in the sight of God. And the Lord sold them into the hand of Jabin, king of Canaan.
Mm-hmm.
He sold them. The hand of God was removed from the Israelites. And the hand of God was on the enemy of his people.
Well.
To oppress them.
Well.
To them, to have them living in poverty,
yes.
To have them depressed,
uh-huh.
To have them probably having all kind of mental breakdown.
Uh-huh.
But the hand of God was removed from them because they continuously did evil again. Does it sound like somebody you know? No matter what you say to them, they keep going back to the evil that they just can't seem to get away from? Huh. We have to stay focused.
Yes.
And after Joshua and all of the judges had passed on, the last judge before that we read about today, which there was others after her, was Deborah. And so God knew that Deborah was faithful. Saints of God, how many times have you found yourself oppressed? How many times have you gone to someone you believed could intercede and get a word in for you?
Mm.
You just needed somebody to pray because you couldn't pray yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You were down so low, you just couldn't get a word out. And it doesn't have to be because you've done evil. Sometimes just because you're so sick and you're so tired, you just can't get a word.
Well,
when I was sick those last 2 years, people would be calling me, and I was saying, you need to pray for me.
Okay.
I can't even pray for myself.
Mm-hmm.
The prayer I have is, oh God, have mercy. Help me, Jesus.
Yeah.
That was my prayer, baby. Because I was so weak and oppressed by my infirmity. But God said, I put you in a rest. The word is in you. You don't have to worry about declaring the word. You don't have to worry about praying for nobody else. It's time for them to pray for you.
Amen.
Sometimes we just need intercession and intercessors.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We cannot do it by ourselves.
Yeah.
God has anointed and appointed us to do something for each other.
Yeah. That's right.
But how many times have you looked for a word and couldn't get one?
Well,
how many times have you looked for someone to intercede for you and
Come on, tell the truth.
How much?
Just church.
Yeah.
But God is not looking for people to be just churchy.
Come on.
His hand is upon us. It is an identifier. It is a seal of God to tell God who we are and to tell the world whose we are. Make sure that the task at hand is done.
Uh-huh.
But she already knew the answer, amen? Number three, saints, God will send instructions. When God gives you instructions, it will be contingent upon your obedience to his word.
Well.
If you do this, then I will do that.
Yes.
How many know we miss our blessings all the time because we want to quote the word of God?
Yeah.
God said he'll do this. God said he'll do that. I'm just waiting on it, but God said I'll do this if you do that.
That's right.
Amen.
If you confess your sins,
that's right.
Then I'm going to forgive you of your sins. Amen.
Yeah.
If you call on my name, then I will show you.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
Yeah.
God shows us what to do. He tells us what to do. And many times we forget about the other part of the agreement. If you need this, then I will do that.
Yeah.
But if you don't do that, then I will remove my hand.
Yeah.
And when I remove my hand, the enemy will put his where mine should be.
Wow.
Did you hear what I said?
That's word. That's word.
We want to stay covered, and we stay covered by being obedient. And a lot of times, even in our own guilt, God blesses us because somebody's interceding.
Woo!
Amen.
Speak.
Amen.
Speak. Speak.
I also want you to remember that when you follow God's instructions, he is faithful.
Yes.
To do just what he said.
Yes.
Point number four is when God's hand is upon you, he equips you for
yes.
that. Many times we just say, well, I can't pray like that, or I don't know how to declare like that, or you know, I don't, somebody called me and said they were sick, but I'm gonna call someone else because I don't know how to lay hands on them. The Bible has already declared that we are anointed.
Yes. Okay.
That if we abide in him and he abides in us, we can ask what we will, and it shall be given.
Hallelujah.
But where's our faith?
First.
Most of us have to say, God, stir up the gift, because my faith is the first thing you need to work on.
Yeah.
Amen.